Hello, this is Will. I'm a real werewolf. Please like and subscribe to this channel if you would, or video or whatever. I've been asked to stop swearing by Louis, so as a favour, I'm going to stop swearing in this bit. Hello, this is Will the Werewolf again. Please subscribe to this channel and like things, and www.werewolf.host is our website that will be up and running in January, I believe, according to Louis, who couldn't afford werewolf.com because he's a cheap bastard. Yeah, there's more information and stuff on there. I think I'm on chapter 35 or some shit, I have no idea. This is about meeting my family, so I'm actually going and meeting the family of werewolves. Up to now, I'd not met any werewolves apart from my wife, which was a bit of a shock. So you can go back and listen to that if you want. And as I say, there's a lot of information in all these things, so you might want to go and listen to the other ones for it to make some sense. Because if you start on this one, it's going to be like not making very much sense. But it's a good story anyway, so I don't know. Fuck it, just do what you want. Right, so family holidays. So I'd met my wife, and now every year that I could, and I was actually allowed by the army to go and go on holiday, believe it or not. Like, they started to trust me quite well. Fucking idiots. But anyway, every year we go away back to her homeland for her family's hunting season. Yep, they have a hunting season. We would fly into Surgut City in Siberia to meet her parents and her big fuck-off extended family. I suppose you would call it a tribe or something like that. From there, and after a big party, we would then make the rest of the journey to buy rental cars into the Ural Mountains to a little town called I don't know, I haven't got the accent away, which her family owns. I mean, they own it. That's where she was born as well. From there, we become wolves and head into the mountains for the days of the hunts. They hunt for meat for the year. They hunt elk, ibex, tur and bear, and humans if they're there. The villagers in that area know to be extremely careful in the late summers in the mountains, to be honest. The first time I went, I was going to be introduced to her parents, you know, the meet the parents first time thing. I never had to meet the parents. I had to eat the parents, but I'd never had to meet the parents. Home in the Kandinsky district of Siberia, she comes from a small village there. Her family have been in the area for hundreds and maybe thousands of years. I've no fucking idea. And they're the latest generation of the Mansai people, apparently. I mean, I've learnt all this shit now. They name themselves the Vogel. I can't say it with a Russian accent. The people here have recently been studied and shown to have the mitochondrial DNA of the first Eurasians. The early tribes got into this area during the Paleolithic era. The Ural Mountains are pretty massive and acted as a barrier to further expansion east of these people. They are it's the home turf of her family. Tribe, or I would actually call it a pack, I suppose. Surgut City itself is a very modern city where her family spend most of the year. They have been here since the days of its creation. In fact, they created it. Even the city's flag sports a big black fuck-off wolf on a yellow and blue background. The flag and the coat of arms celebrate the wolves that actually run and own this city. Her father is a somewhat reclusive businessman, immensely wealthy, an actual for real oligarch, with his money gained from the huge gas and oil industry that the wolves monopolize in the area. He also owns the infrastructure of the fair city. He has two giant power plants. He totally controls the shipping industry, having a total grasp on what goes in and out of the enormous port there on the river. His brother is a renowned politician in the area, and between them they are gods and guardians for the province, either as wolf or in its human form, to be honest. And they do have links with Kolotov and Vladimir Putin, the famous werewolf leader of Russia. Her father is called Almoko. The Moko part has those funny little dots over the top of the O's that make it sound very cooler than normal. The name, again, hints at his heritage as the wolf that he is. The owl bit comes from owl or moon, and the Moko means strong man. Such a great name for an alpha werewolf if they actually existed. The first time we flew into Surgut, I have to admit that I was shitting my pants. I wouldn't say I was a little bit nervous, I was pretty scared. After her telling me about her family and her pack, I realised that these were actual very influential people and they were very powerful. These types do not generally frighten me, but I never met anyone that I could not destroy. This was very different, though. In this case, you had a family of, well, of werewolves, a family made up of gods like me. After my due diligence and research, I found that they had more financial power than most countries, or most small countries anyway, far more than Great Britain. We were met at the airport the first time we landed there by two of her brothers. Oh, and this is nothing like the movies. They did not look like black leather jackety cool guys or sharply dressed business people. They just looked kind of Russian to me, to be honest. I know that's me being stereotypical, but they did. Maybe a bit hairier than the average guy and a little bit longer in the canine tooth, but that was it. Their posits were huge. One black, one grey, and both eyed my posit with a bit of distrust and greeted the posit of their sister happily. We watched them play in the centre of the arrivals area, unseen by any others, but we could see him, but no one else. The brothers greeted and hugged their sibling, laughing as they watched the playing posits. My posit sat on the edge of the others as they played, scratching his head and waiting to be welcomed. I did the same, quietly watching the family reunion. This was a big step for me to take. Would I be accepted or would I be not? Eventually, the posits stopped their greeting and turned towards mine. They stalked up to him, but he held his ground as the unknown posit circled him. He was not going to be submissive. I felt proud of him. The human family reunion stopped at this point and they turned towards me. Three pairs of predator's eyes focused directly at me. I actually felt a little fear and a bit of a thrill, to be honest. She whispered in each of her brother's ears and they smiled in response and laughed as she held the men's hands and brought them skipping to meet me. "This is Will," she said. They smiled and laughed and they were greeting me as though I was a long-lost brother. Each hugged me hard and I felt their strength. It felt like I was home. They genuinely seemed pleased to see me and it felt like I'd already been accepted. It was the first time I felt family apart from Fern, my posit, or maybe feelings of family. I'm really not sure. They were dressed in warm layers and looked ordinary. I looked around for security and any other posits in the area, but I could not see any. I then realised that they did not really need any support or security. They were the fucking monsters that had nothing to fear. Her father was a little untrusting when we first met. He had not heard of werewolves in other parts of the world. I think he was genuinely fascinated to try and find out my history and how I gained my posit wolf soul. He would sit with our posits deep into the night while we spoke about my past, and my posit would tell him of his many generational histories. He spoke of the posit's journey from these mountains and into Western Europe and how he had travelled even further west into America and South America. It was a history I knew well from learning and chatting it through with my posit, but for Al it was genuinely fascinating. Al did not tell me the whole of what he thought about my posit's history. He did not recognise Fenrir as a posit from the past, or at least he didn't show me that he recognised Fenrir as a posit from the past. And Al was one of the original werewolf tribes, so he really should have known. This became a bit of an issue. In my later story, you will understand all this if you listen to the next couple of stories. The Ural Mountains are a wild place, a harsh place, a place where the hunting is the only way to stay alive. Her people were the first werewolves, apparently. They made some spiritual pact with a wolf pack up there, the wolves releasing their spirits as posits so they and the people could live on in such a harsh place. It had been a long, enduring journey, and we had the stink of the humans all of us, so, yeah, through our interaction with them. And our 14-plus hours of flying and then 16-hour drive. Yeah, you read that right, a 16-fucking-hour drive. That's normal to Russian people. You know, we're just going out for the day. Where are you going over there? How long is it going to be? 16 hours. It's a pain in the ass, isn't it? So, yeah, it was a 16-hour drive to hometown. Her hometown is a shithole, to be honest.